Good morning, everyone. Thank you for being a part of our baccalaureate mass, because as we have learned from the teachings of Blessed Basil Moreau, it is not the place that makes people holy, rather it is the people that make the place holy. I was amazed at the number of cars I saw as I arrived this morning in the parking lot. Class, I can't help but think that today would be a perfect day for all of us to get up and go block the hill again. Even though, or unlike the time during homecoming week when we blocked the hill out of passion for the Spirit's sake, this time it would be because we don't want to leave. We don't want to leave our beautiful home, dear old cathedral. In this morning's reading from 2 Timothy, we heard, "I have competed well, I have finished the race, I have kept the faith." Tomorrow, as we are gathered for our commencement, Cathedral's class of 2016 will finish the race. We seem to have given every possible ounce of our love, courage, perseverance, and passion to Cathedral and her people. But we know tomorrow, and next fall, and in 10 years, there will be other races, other trials that we must finish well. And we will. We have faith. It is that faith that has helped us throughout our past 4 years at Cathedral. Our legacy will live on through the people whose lives we've touched with our humor, our compassion, and our love. We are a class of angels, both heavenly and earthly. Just as we heard in the gospel this morning, we are a class that has followed God's instructions of loving others as he loves us. Our teachers and fellow students will remember our spirit, a spirit that is not embodied by a stick, but by our acts of kindness. I am proud of our positive impact, and I am proud to be a member of the class of 2016. Let's face it, the world needs our minds, our humor, and most of all, our love. Tomorrow, we will finish this race, but it is not our last race, nor our last step. It is just our next step together. We are ready to move. Psalm 73, verse 23 reads, "But now I am always with you, for you keep holding my right hand." As God has held our hands throughout our past 4 years at Cathedral, he will continue to hold our hands. So let's show our solidarity by holding each other's hands as God holds ours. Class, please all join hands together. Think back to the first time we held hands, way back to our first freshman year mass, where we were oblivious to how close our class would become and how impactful our loving class would be. Think back to the time we held hands as we danced the freshman welcome dance in front of the whole school as we were welcomed into the Cathedral family. Think back to the time we held hands our sophomore year as we stormed the field and cheered on our classmates at the Cathedral versus Chitara football game. Think back to holding hands in a circle, releasing balloons, and praying as we honored and mourned the loss of our dearest Tacy. Together, we were able to keep our faith during our journey of grieving and healing. Think back to holding hands while celebrating our theatrical performances, academic achievements, musical productions, sporting accomplishments, and countless other successes. We held hands in triumph as we finally won something for the first and last time, junior year at Irish Epitome. This year, we held on to one another and the sophomore class as we faced another tragedy, the loss of Jen. We did everything we could to help them through a pain we knew so well and share with them our ways of keeping the faith and spreading our love. Many of us held hands at retreat closings, retreat prayer services, and maybe even a few retreat parties. Think about all the times we have held hands in this sacred place, in this journey. We hold hands right now, Cathedral Class of 2016, and show the power of love and the power of unity. We celebrate as one. We have finished the race. We have kept our faith. Thank you to my parents and to all the other Cathedral parents for allowing us to be a part of our home on the hill. Thank you to the teachers who have taught us all the right words, even though right now I'm almost speechless and I seem to be unable to fully express. express our class's gratitude toward you all. Just as I am unable to fully express how thankful I am for my class and how much I love them. In one of my favorite books, there is a passage that reads, "The night that seemed endless hours before is now slipping from your fingers, ticking by as it falls into the past and pushes you toward the future." Class of 2016, let us thank Cathedral, our teachers, our parents, our family and friends, and our faith communities for preparing us for this moment that seems so far away before. This is the moment for us to say goodbye together, leave together, and move on into the world together. This is the moment where we finish this race, but we start a new one together in our race for the future. Friends, class of 2016, in order for us to leave something great behind, we first must leave. May God's peace follow us always.